Today, we are going to practically demonstrate the in situ wheel changing process through in situ wheel changing equipment developed by Jamalpur Locomotive Workshop. We are aware that a wagon detached from the load for wheel changing purpose takes about 4 to 5 days for getting reattached after fitness at slick line, whereas the quantum of wheel changing work is about 4 to 5 hours only. In case the wheel changing activity is attended in situ at yard, saving of about 4 to 5 days per wagon primarily on account of shunting can be achieved, which has the potential for saving of several hundred crores of rupees per annum. For this reason, development of in situ wheel changing equipment has been conceptualized and developed by Jamalpur Locomotive Workshop. Now I am going to introduce with various parts of the equipment. The in situ wheel changing equipment has three units, namely set of 15 tons hydraulic jack, two numbers with 700 mm lifting capacity, controlled by a double acting hand operated hydraulic pump, having 5 liters oil tank capacity with working pressure of 350 kg per square centimeter. Two sets of wheel changing trolley assembly fitted with hand pump operated hydraulic jack for lifting wheel set and fitted with pulling handle. A pair of sliding channels to be fitted perpendicular to the railway track over which trolley assembly will move. Now the sequence of activities will be as follows. In fact, the in situ wheel changing process starts with detection of wagon with defective wheel set. The diameter of the defective wheel set is measured and a good wheel set with matching diameter is brought to the site for exchange. As we know that maximum allowed wheel diameter variation in the same trolley is 13 mm and 25 mm between the trolleys. There are some preparatory works which we have done before the main operation, such as site preparation, which include leveling work for easy movability of wheel changing trolleys, as well as for base preparation of holding of lifting jacks. There are a few pre-lifting activities also, which are to be complied to ensure smooth and effective lifting. First of all, we will ensure fitment of central pivot pin shackle and quarter, binding of all axle box adapters with wire, and placement of inserts between the bolster and the side frame, with a view to restrict relative movement between them, to enable us lifting of wagon along with the bogey. We will also ensure fitment of skids to prevent rolling down of wagon during wheel changing operation. Fitment of sliding channels perpendicular to the railway track over which the wheel changing trolley will move is also a part of the pre-lifting activity, as it is unsafe to fit this during the process of lifting. Since all the pre-lifting activities have been complied, now we are in a position to start lifting of wagon along with the bogey. Lifting has to be done sufficiently to ensure easy removal and or insertion of wheel changing trolley loaded with defective or good wheel set. Now the lifting process is going on and we are performing the lifting operation simultaneously through both the lifting jacks controlled by hand operated hydraulic pump. While the lifting process is going on, now we are placing the matching diameter good wheel set already brought to the site on the other wheel changing trolley assembly. And bringing it near to the wheel changing location with the help of handle attached with it. Now we see that sufficient lifting has been done. Lifting process is completed. Now we are placing one set of wheel changing trolley assembly fitted with hydraulic hand pump for lifting the wheel set placed on it and from under the wagon. Now the process of removal of bad wheel set starts and we are manually rolling down the bad wheel set and placing it on the trolley. After placing, we are now lifting the bad wheel set on the trolley by operating the hydraulic hand pump provided with the trolley. Trolley loaded with bad wheel, pulling by the handle attached with it. Now the process of insertion of good wheel set will commence. Now we are pushing as well as pulling the trolley loaded with good wheel set inside the wagon and over the sliding channels fitted perpendicular to the track. Now we are in a position to dismount the good wheel set on railway track, and we are dismounting by releasing the pump. And the good wheel is dismounted on the railway track safely. Now we are rolling the wheel over the track and placing under axle box glide. Now the good wheel set has been positioned and we are ready for lowering operation. Before lowering operation, we are removing the under the wagon. Now we are lowering the wagon body along with the box through the hand pump. Of the wagon is completed successfully. Now we have to perform a few post-lowering activity also. Inserts put between the bolster and the side frame key are taken off. Wires of all the adapters are removed. Thereby the entire process of in-situ wheel changing through in-situ wheel changing equipment developed by Jamalpur Locomotive Workshop is completed with great success. Timing for the entire wheel changing operation comes to about 2.5 hours, take-up of which can be seen in the table. Site preparation 25 to 35 minutes, pre-lifting activities 25 minutes, lifting of wagon 25 to 35 minutes, removal of bad wheel set 10 to 15 minutes, insertion of good wheel set 10 to 15 minutes, lowering of wagon 15 minutes, post-lowering activities 10 minutes, a total of 120 to 150 minutes, precisely about 2.5 hours. The total time taken of about 2.5 hours matches with the intensive examination time and therefore can be completed within the intensive examination time period. Thank you.